Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Anandu Kumari, GLT District Coordinator of representing the District 324B1, and my home club is Lions Club of Ramnagar. Friends, I believe in the proverb, if one door is closed, definitely a window is open. Though by profession I'm a lecturer, due to family commitments, I have to resign my job. I found the platform of again teaching to the children through when I became a president. I took 100 leadership seminars, and the passion, I thought the fire was extinguished. But unfortunately, it was not extinguished. The amber was there, I was able to pick up the cord, and then I was able to do 100 leadership programs. Then later on, when I was a GLT, with the collaboration of more presidents, secretaries and treasurer, the target groups were not 100 for me, it was more than 100, it was 300 leadership seminars I was able to do. Then that year, we had the club excellence process. I was able to do 35 clubs, club excellence process. The year last year, again, I was a GLT member, district coordinator. Again, I was able to have the target of having 10,000 students, and 22 clubs were done the club excellence process. This year, our district governor has got a target of doing the club excellence process again for 22 clubs, and again, the target for doing the leadership is for 20,000 students. Already we have achieved 15,000 students. The last one more month, June month, we are going to achieve the target. Friends, my topic given to you is on communication skills. You will know that communication is a process where two people are involved. There is a process, in the process, there is a sender and there is a receiver. And before teaching you the do's in communication, I thought it will be more effective. With this still, if I'm going to communicate, the don'ts in a communication, the ineffectiveness in a communication is reflected in this. Can you interpret what is there in this still?
Yeah, there is a mismatch. The lines should have come in some other way, but the lines, you know, the train.
Railway track.
There were no proper communication, so both
the tracks were not being.
Only one is.
What about you, my dear friend?
They were told to put a track,
yes,
but they didn't put the right.
They didn't keep the final objective in their mind.
So the communication was not. There was a mismatch. There was a distrust. There was a conflict. Because of that conflict, the desired effects were not matched. See, they're all working in team, or they're working in individual?
Team.
Team. So teamwork. Teamwork, what does teamwork indicate? It enhances productivity. Because your energy and my energy are synergizing together, so there will be innovation, there will be creativity, and all this leads to productivity. But here, nothing happened because of this mismatch of communication. Now, can any one of you read the session objectives?
Yeah, recognize the communication process.
Yes. What did they do?
Next. Yeah.
Yes.
Recognize the communication process.
Yes.
Identify effective communication skills.
Yes.
Utilize effective communication skills.
Good.
Promote cross-level communication within the district.
Yes. Before I start, I thought we'll have an activity to reinforce that communication is a two-way process. Please have this paper till I give you the instruction. You have to be patiently waiting. Now, as soon as you are, I hope you all have received the paper. When I'm giving the instructions, you have to close your eyes but follow what I'm telling you. Okay? Kindly close your eyes. Fold the paper into two. Again, fold the paper into two. Tear the right hand corner of the paper.
Tear it.
Then again fold it. Tear again the right hand corner of the paper. Then tear the left hand side of the paper. Finished. Have you finished?
Yeah.
Abhijit, doctor?
Yes.
finding it difficult to tear it? Okay, no, now we can open the eyes. Let us test and see whether each and every one of us had in the same manner. I told you, I gave you only 6 instructions. It was in a constant flow. Fold, fold, tear, fold, tear, fold. That's all. Why it is not similar? There is discord.
Perception.
Where was the lack in perception? It was very simple task I gave you. It was just fold. It was not a complicated one. Fold, 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 tear. That's all. What was the thing
when
you failed?
Fold, other time it killed me, other fold. So what you are doing, maybe
you received
right.
The ideas.
Your left and my left differed. You said left, I thought my left. You must be saying your left. That differed.
So the information, how was the information?
It was not precise.
Yes, information was not precise. Information had been precise, the result would have been proper.
Different.
It would have been different. And remember, when we are doing an activity, activity always needs demonstration. And when we are demonstrating, when you have any doubts, it should be followed by question and answers. Here, only I was there, you were not given a chance to respond through in the form of question and answer. Because of that, there is a mismatch in what I expected and what the net result you showed me. Okay? Now, we have to realize that communication is a process, and for that we have to go for a definition. Would you say, Abhijit, would you just read what is the definition?
A two-way process in which participants exchange thoughts, messages or information through speech, signals, writings or behavior.
Yes. Communication from time immemorial is found between human beings, and communication is a powerful thought of the tool of a powerful thought. It is not only found in human beings, it is found in animal kingdom, insect kingdom, everywhere. For example, the bee with its fluttering of the dance, it is able to indicate where the nectar is. Likewise, the baboon, when it is just stamping on the fist on its chest, it is able to say, denote he is in a jubilant mood. So communication is not only found in human beings, communication is found in animal kingdom and in insect kingdom. And for communication, it is a two-way process. Will you just turn to your page number 1 in your participant manual? What is the figure it indicates? The communication must have a sender and a receiver. The sender sends a message. The receiver receives the message. On the receipt of the message, he is again able to send back a message. So, the communication is not, it is a continual process. It is a continual process. It is indicates that it is a continuous process. And as it is a continual process, the sender becomes a receiver, the receiver becomes the sender. It is a circular process. And through this process, we are able to establish a truth that it is an art, it is not a framework where we can put it in a definition that as a mathematical formula, 1 plus 1 is 1, or as a science we can say that a water molecule contains 2 oxygen molecules and 1 hydrogen molecule. The main reason is human brain is a complex activity, the communication is a thought process which is also a complex one. And language is in which when you communicate is arbitrary. So communication is an ongoing process. It is a process. It is an art. It is definitely not a science. Okay. Now, again, I want to say what are the elements of communication. We understood from the figure we need 2 persons to communicate. The one who sends the message is called as a source. He is a sender. Then he is called also the encoder. He sends the message. What is that? The participant exchange thoughts, messages or information. He sends a message and the message is being encoded. For encoding, we need a media or a channel. Here, what is the media? This is a digital channel. So we have to encode it. Then the encoding is received by the receiver. He decodes it. Then again, he perceives some things and then he gives back the what he has received it, he gives back to the messenger, to the sender, the source. So it is a vicious circle. It is ongoing and ongoing. That's why it is an art. It's not a science. And again, there are few characteristics to define that Communication is really a process and it is an art. There are 7 C's which, when we are able to adhere to a communication, we will notify and we will really vouchsafe that a communication will be a real communication. The first C we have to take it note is that the communication must be really complete. Though I gave you an instruction, you are not able to do it in a complete manner because lots of doubts, minds, you had lots of questions in your mind because the communication, the command I gave you is not complete. It should be very concise. It should be concise. It should be small. It should be time saving. It should be, there should not be any repetition of the information. It should be appealing. The third one, the communication must be really correct. You should be very concise, you should be correct in your information. There should not be any falsehood. There must be a note of sincerity and truth in your communication, what you want to communicate through your message. The fourth is that there should be concreteness. There should be a match between what the facts you say and what the figures you want to quote. When it is concrete, it depends upon the word selection. The words must be clear, concise, whereas which carry the message of clarity. And when we are doing this, the receiver's mind also must be taken into account. We should not hurt psychologically the receiver, so we have to be considerate when you are giving the message. At the same time, you have to be courtesy. There must be a level of courtesy when you are communicating with them. We should be very polite. We should not hurt anybody's feeling. And 2 C's, S's also taken into consideration. Got to be very simple. The communication must be very simple and it must be very sincere. Now we have understood that it is a process, and why do we need communication skills as you are in the helm of affairs as in the DG team? Why communication skills is very imperative for you? Communication is a live wire for a leader to grow. Unless and otherwise you master communication, you will never be a great leader. If communication slips, it will be like the activity what we have done. Communication is a live wire which takes you to higher ladder of success. So all great communicators, remember my friends, they were only great leaders. The great leaders are always great communicators. Now, have you understood the first objective? That communication is a process, the process which engages 2 people. So let us move on to the skills of communication. But now we said it is an art. When it is an art, we need some, any process need a communication skill. You should need some skills. And we know that communication has a language, and language has got 4 different components for enhancing your skills. They are called as L, S, R, W. Can you just guess what the L stands for?
Learning.
Listening. Listening. Yes stands
speaking.
For? Speaking. Yes, speaking. R stands likewise?
Response.
Reading.
Response.
Then?
Writing.
Yes. And if we are able to denote this factor with 100% it is very interesting to know that 45% in your life we spend in intensive listening. The rest of the 4 skills are divided, which we don't need now. 45% in our life we spend in listening. Now, Binoy sir, would you just lead? What are the 4 skills for effective communication?
Active listening.
Yes.
Non-verbal communication.
Sure.
Direct expression.
Very good.
Giving or receiving feedback.
Yes. Now, you have understood what is communication. Now, we have to be acquainted with the skills of communication. After acquainting, we have to master. And after mastery, we have to produce. What you have learned, you have to produce, prepare and present in a different thing. That is the 4th level, giving and feeding feedback and how you are going to do that. Okay, now active listening. What is the difference between hearing and listening? Can you give an example? Where there is a thin difference between hearing and listening?
Listening can be retaining within yourself.
What about hearing?
Hearing is something you are just present here. Probably you may not hear whichever is important you may take, all other rest you leave it.
What about doctor?
Actively not listening, my thoughts, just whatever
yes.
you are saying.
Hearing is just gathering of sounds in your mind. And you have the scaffolding, you can chunk, you can do all this process in hearing. But when it comes for listening, that is entirely different. You have written, there are some strategies when you have to follow what is meant by active listening. See, when you are listening, you have to be attentive. You have to be attentive, not physically, mentally also, because listening is a process which is based on a mental process. You listen, you assimilate things, and you associate things, then you represent it in the form of a, decode it in the form of a message. So definitely it is a mental process. So as it is a mental process, you have to be mentally, physically alert. And as you are mentally, physically alert, there are again four stages when you are receiving the message. You have to first be attentive, you have to understand the message, you have to evaluate the message, then you have to give it back to the receiver. When this process, all these things happen within a few short the span of time inside your internal process. So when you are doing this, you should not too much rely on the memory. There are chances for you to have some slips. So as soon as you receive a message, better thing, the most advantage is that jot it down. When you jot it down, what it has, you have created an authority. You have created an authority, there won't be any slips. Even when you give back to the sender, the receiver, you will say that this is what has happened. The communication was complete because you have jotted it down. Again, there is another advantage is that you are paying indirectly a tribute to the sender that you have not slipped anything when the message was given to you. So that is an advantage. But while we are just receiving this, you have no right to offer any judgment. Inferences, judgments are reserved because you have only a part on receiving it and then only you are just decoding and sending back. Then, when you want to have any clarity, what you should do? The whole message has to be divided into parts and passes, pieces. Then you have to paraphrase it for clarity. Then you have to assimilate on what you have received the message and you have to present. When you are going to present back again what you have received to the sender, again the parts are just made into whole, you are summarizing what it has happened and you are going to submit back this, the process back to the sender. Okay, now the first skill is active listening. Have you ever been an active listener in your life? There are stages for you to be an active listener. Can you just quote an anecdote?
Anecdote? You want me to tell?
Yeah, personally, okay. Share your experiences.
Whenever people are doing public speaking, we need to listen to them what they are trying to speak. If I speak, then I can understand what really they are doing it. They are going to transfer a knowledge.
Yes.
How much knowledge I am going to gain from that?
How much you are going
important.
To imbibe? Every day is a learning experience.
Yes.
So you have to learn through that what you have learned. Okay, very good. Now, communication also has got three types of communication. One is verbal communication. The verbal communication is again subdivided into oral and written communication. The second one is called as the non-verbal communication. The third one is called as the visual communication. Again, it can be categorized as personal and non-personal. It can be categorized, each and every communication can be categorized as personal and non-personal. And we have told time and again that it's a process which needs two people. It needs a message, it's a source, a decoding, encoding, all this process is there needed for communication, we said. It is very interesting to see that even in non-verbal communication, we can establish beautiful communication. The communication will not be marred for that. The example is facial expression. The next one is
body,
what? Body,
movements
and posture. Third one is gestures. The fourth one is eye contact. See, why facial expression is very, very needed? Without a single word of utterance of a syllable or a word, the communication has been understood. Imagine a dancer performing on a stage and on the audience side, the Navarasas, according to the Natya Shastras, it is extremely poignantly she is reflecting on this on her face and we are able to understand all the fine shades of emotion starting from laughter, ending with peace. So we are able to Identify each and every shade of the emotion very perfectly on the face. The next is body movement. The body movements also plays a very decisive role in the role of communication. See, the way you stand, the way you, what you position yourself, also communicate strong meaning and message to the person who is communicating the message. See, when your shoulders are right, that shows that you are in tune with the sender and the receiver are in tune. But when you are sitting and your shoulders are in a slouching posture, that shows that you are non-interested. Who cares what you are going to tell? I am not respecting, I am not interested. That is the message non-verbally you are able to convey through your posture, sitting posture. Suppose if I come closer to you and if you just turn your side, that shows that you are not respected in what I am going to communicate. That also is an indicative. You are showing that you are not interested in the communication I am offering to you. The third one is gestures. Gestures can be intentionally or unintentionally, it also plays a decisive role. But gestures has got a cultural connotation. In certain different countries, gestures have a different connotation. But gestures also play an important role. In the same manner, the jubilant mood can be expressed in the gesture in the form of thumbs up. And when your spirits are down, when you are not elated, when you are totally crushed and crashed, when you just put your thumbs down, you are able to convey the poignant feeling, the powerful feeling of emotions are being easily understood. Likewise, eye contact, when the face is the index of the mind, eyes are the key which opens the heart and your brain. Eyes also are able to portray all powerful feelings. But when you are a communicator, you will be a successful communicator only when you are able to establish eye contact. Remember, my dear friends, you are no longer a zone or a region. Now you are in a great responsible position. You must be able to hold eye contact, because when you hold an eye contact, there is a great advantage. You make the person to bring that you are in closer fold. There is a confidence level is being established, and you say that we are in one with that. You are making them to bring them to a comfort zone. So the comfort zone helps you to achieve more productivity, because we are in an organization where all level of people are there. So eye contact is very, very essential, needed for you to establish as a very great leader. And I want to know that, is any other place where you can, other than these four places, where you can communicate in a non-verbal manner effectively, other than these four which I have mentioned here in the still?
When I am speaking to someone who is dumb.
Sign language.
When you are doing scuba diving, you need to signalize the trainer.
That is gesture. That is also gesture. Sign language gesture, that is gesture only.
So underwater, you cannot communicate to
sign language. There. So you have experienced that. And the next one, direct expression. Remember, you are going to communicate as a DG team, to the zone, the RCPs, and to the club levels. Instead of using I, if we use you, what will be the disadvantages? You have, when you use you, there are three negative states of meaning. You will put yourself into blame, into accusations, and to severe strong criticism. Instead, if you use the word direct expression I, what happens? See, and before going to that, in the active listening, there is an activity, turn to page number 5. It is a homework. Don't do it now. It is an appraisal of you to know where you were, whether and when and where you were an active listener. Okay? Okay. Now, and again to turn to page number 7. There are a few instances in your five instances are there where the you can be rephrased into I.
Page 5.
Where instead of using you, if you rephrase it with the word I, when subjective is put, when you use as I, how well the effects will be there. Vinoy, can we read what the first example, other than what it has been quoted in the still? Second one, can you follow the second one?
You know that's not the right solution. I see a different solution to the problem.
Yes. Whatever you want to say, don't be subjective. When you are subjective, it becomes an hostile atmosphere is created. If you refrain yourself, if you put it in a different manner, the efforts are entirely rewarding. Can you just read the third one, Mr. Abhijit?
You know that's not the right solution. And if you use I see a different solution to the problem.
Yes. See, instead of saying that, I see a different solution, you are more positive. You are extremely positive. So the results will be as you want to be. Can you just have your Salke, sir?
When I want to say, you never include me in decisions. Mm. But the statement I need to use is, I would like to contribute my ideas before a decision is made.
Yes, we are all working in a team, so you can say that I will like to be happy if I'm included and if my suggestions are offered. So this is how the direct expression plays an important role. Have we ever come across an occasion where the direct expression has fetched you some rewards as a district governor team? When and where were you able to use this direct expression? There must be some occasion when you are addressing the joint chairperson or a president of this club. I would be happy if you are able to conduct, if we ask you for a special visit of the club, that day you are very busy, you can rephrase, say that, I would be happy if it will be on some other time. You would have used, consciously, unconsciously, you would have used it. You're not able to retrieve it back, but unconsciously, consciously, you use only I when you talk it with on a personal touch to your PSGs. Okay, then the fourth one. Is giving and receiving feedback. See, feedback is very, very imperative for one person to grow because it assists you where you are and will take you where you want to go to scale to greater heights to have a new dimension in your presentation. It need not be in your line life. Wherever you are, if you get a feedback, it will help you to accentuate your strength and it will lessen your weakness. As a gardener is pruning the weeds and is pruning the trees, when we just depend on feedback, definitely the feedback is going to give us a long way, a long road to help us to go. There are certain steps when we are receiving the feedback. The first thing is that we have to be very, very supportive. When you are going to receive or give a feedback, you have to be very supportive. There must be a positive note. You have to help them to grow. You should not be very blunt. You should not be very authoritative. You should not be influential when you are offering your feedback, when you are giving your feedback. The second one, that you have to be direct. Direct, you focus on what you wanted as a feedback. Hit the nail hard. Don't need to beat around the bush. Then you have to be very specific. What are the needs? Are they catering to the specific? Again, focus is there. You have to be very specific on what you need as a feedback. The third one, today I want you to do an assessment of what I've done. And if I give you a feedback, you should not say that I'll carry it home. I don't find time. I'll put it tomorrow. I'll post it. It should be time associated, time oriented. Then only the feedback is really a feedback. These are the steps which has to be followed during giving feedback. The third one is, the next one is receiving feedback. The process is a two-way process. It's like the two sides of a coin, receiving and giving, which helps to grow in both ways, either ways. So when you are receiving the feedback, you have to be an active listener, like an avid reader. You should be an active listener. You have to listen actively. When you are in the process of listening, you can ask for more questions, because questions and answers will always elucidate where you are. It will reinforce how you have taken, how you are, and it is only a retrospection of what you have done. So far, where you are, where it's going to take, question and answer is again a tool which will help you to grow. Then, while you are asking more questions, remember, don't give room for any debates. We should refrain ourselves from any debate. If there is any hostile atmosphere, if there is any conflict, you should be very tactfully, you should know to hold the authority of refraining that debate inside the feedback. Then, the feedback is a process. It is going to evaluate yourself in your own timeline, the feedback is definitely a tool which will help you to grow. It is going to give a credibility where you are, what you want to be. If you are really positive about your growth, the feedbacks are really a tool which will help you to evaluate, because they are, if they are authentic, because there are two advantages and disadvantages in the feedback. Either it take you to great heights or it will you will be crushed when the feedbacks comes. And if it all depends upon how well you are able to take the morale and how well you are going to do it. And now I think it's time for us again to do an activity to say that you have really understood the skills and how effectively you are going to put the skills. What are the four skills? Active listening, then
non-verbal communication.
Non-verbal communication.
Fish.
The third one is direct expression. Fish. Then fourth one is giving and
or receiving feedback.
Receiving feedbacks. So I'll give you 10 minutes time and turn to your module. There is a scenario, either in a district convention or in the DG team is having a telephonic conversation about a service activity which is going to take place. So now I want to take on the role active listening. Take three of you, take time to prepare the role time, role play. The time allocated is 10 minutes. After that, you have to do the role play. That time allocated is 2 minutes. For that, 2 minutes are needed.
Things too fast.
So DGT, you are meeting with the DG? Each group will create a role play illustrating the usage of their assigned communication skill in a district situation. Situations may include a district cabinet or a committee meeting, a conference call between members of the district governor team on the site at the district convention or during district service project. It's going to be DGT who are going to talk on the service activity, right?
Yes.
Service.
The service activity?
Yeah.
You can ponder upon a diabetes camp.
Okay. Okay. It's an international service activity.
Yes.
So you be the district governor. You be the district governor.
So you are communicating with
Yeah.
It is a telephone communication.
It's a telephonic communication with three of us. Okay. You are the first
conference call.
It's a conference call.
Second meeting.
Take time, 10 more minutes.
Okay. Right.
2 minutes for presentation.
Okay. So we are going to do the project in a place. Okay. We are going to have the communication, like where, what, and what things to be taken care of. Then we will be talking that what you are going to do and what you are going to do. And you are going to make a team of yours. And then the team is going to work for yourself. You are going to form your own team. Okay, the program is after 15 days. Okay. So we are planning right now. So maybe after 5 days, we will come back and meet. Okay. Any additions?
So we are using the active learning skills, isn't it?
Yeah, active learning. We are using the mobile phone and con call we are talking. First VDG and then second VDG. Okay. I'll first call you, then I'll say that I'm going to put second VDG also onto the con call.
Okay.
And then three of us will be speaking. So use your mobile phone, keep it.
Okay.
Use your mobile phone, keep it with you. Anyway. Mm. So we are going to be on the con call and then we are going to talk about the activity. And then ek bar rehearsal kare? Sure. Okay.
Give the call.
Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Yeah. Hello.
Hello, how are you, Diji?
Fine, Diji. How's life?
Good, going, sir.
Yeah, alright.
Good, I'm meeting with the meeting.
So, what are things? You are a GLT leader. What's happening now?
Sir. I'm looking for club extension as well.
Yeah.
So, you were talking that day something
about... You are a GLT, na? So, license for GLT.
Yes.
So, what leadership programs you are planning?
I'm planning for district leadership institute soon.
Okay.
So that we will have good quality leaders.
Then see one thing, we'll do one thing. The purpose of leadership is to have more activities and right. then more better. So what I do is I put on con call to our second VDG.
Okay.
Then we'll try to do it. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, one sec. Yeah, Binoy.
Hello.
Yeah, yeah. How are you?
Fine, good afternoon,
fine.
Sir.
Yeah, fine, great, great. How are you?
Fit and fine.
Yeah, on the con call we have again the first VDG.
Oh. Hello,
Binoy.
Good,
okay.
good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
How are you?
Good afternoon.
Yeah. How's so,
fine,
all
fine,
well?
Fine, fine.
Yeah. See, we are trying to do something for leadership or other things, you know, like making members to develop. Okay? Basically, we'll talk on this. Right. We are ready, madam?
Yeah,
can
ready.
We start?
Rehearsal ko video kar di.
Chalta yaar.
Yes, you can. I gave you 7 more minutes left.
Yeah, totally
12
minutes. Okay. Yeah.
Yes.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
Abhijit.
Yes, yes, hello.
Yeah, how are you?
I'm good, sir.
How is life?
Good, good, all
doing well?
Yes, yes, doing well.
Kya GLT liaison officer, kya chal raha hai kaam?
Yes, I'm planning for a district leadership institute soon, maybe in your city.
Okay.
So, we'll be having good quality leaders coming up.
Who is going to be the faculty there?
We'll call few of the FDI faculties from neighboring districts.
Sangeeta madam ko bula sakte na?
Yes, yes, she's an excellent
teacher. She can travel from Calcutta to
Hyderabad. Yes, yes, she'll surely come.
Pune.
Yes, yes,
yeah.
Definitely.
Okay, 1 minute. We are going to have a camp in next 15 days about diabetes.
Okay, sir.
Because this leadership also helps us, the members, to do some better activities. So I put on con call our second VDG.
Right.
One sec, give me a time. Yeah, Binoy.
Good afternoon,
yeah,
sir.
Yeah, how are you?
Fit and fine.
Kya ho raha hai?
All well.
Membership kya hal hai?
It's working. Let's see. Two new clubs are going to be chartered.
Okay.
Have consulted the respective zone chairperson and region chairperson.
Mm.
Keeping fingers crossed.
Achha, chalo, theek hai. What we do is, we are doing in next 15 days a diabetes camp. Okay. What we do is, it's one of the best international activity what we can really focus. And then, you know, like both of you are going to form your teams. Okay. In next 5 days, we are going to meet.
Sorry to interrupt you, sir. Where is the activity?
Kopargaon hai na, Shirdi ke paas.
Okay, okay.
We are doing there. Okay.
Which date? The international?
15 days.
International?
15 days from now, maybe 7th or 8th March, April. I'm sorry. Okay.
Why don't we do it on the International Diabetes Day?
International Diabetes Day, both lamba hai na.
Okay. Okay, as you say, sir.
Yeah, both lamba hai, we'll do it na. 7th April, we'll plan it. It's being a Sunday.
Sure.
And then, you know, like, I believe Shirdi is very close and then a lot of people come. Then we'll be making our image building activity too there.
Right, right. Very
so,
right.
What I suggest you is, you know, like, you make your teams and then get the things done. Okay. We'll talk in next 5 days again. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Yeah. Bye. See you both.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yes. So, through this act, we are able to reiterate the fact that active listening plays a decisive role in the role of communication. And before I go to move on to the other thing, and we were talking about the giving and receiving feedbacks. Have there been any occasion where you were able to give feedback and receive the feedback in your district? Did it play an important role, giving and receiving feedbacks?
Yes, it surely makes.
It surely makes. As a VDG2, what was your role to promote that feedback and receiving feedback? Have you helped in receiving, giving feedback?
Yeah.
Can you just give an anecdote or a personal experience where giving and receiving feedback really accentuated the process of communication?
Madam, as you know that lions don't accept most of the times the feedback. They always want excellent, excellent, excellent. So what we do is, you know, like we take them to the side and tell that this would be the best way of doing things. You know, like.
So you refrain
yeah.
and you reform your
statement and, yeah.
and you are able to get a somewhat a desired
yeah.
result. Okay. Now, this we have understood what is meant by communication, what is the process of communication, recognize what is communication is a process and how the skills you have now acquainted yourself. And we have now mastered the skills, and mastery of the skill has been reflected in your role play, that effective listening skill you have really mastered. Now let us move on to the next module. Now the last module in an objective is that how you are going to present the you are becoming a great communicator, and a great communicator needs a test. The test is that how we are going to promote this cross communication in your district as a VDG1. You have prepared yourself. You are now going to project and present how you are going to be really an effective communicator. See, communication as a VDG, you are in the GAT team, the Global Action Team, and you are responsible for many of the changes what the DG requires. Only through you only he can have. You are the GAT team and you are going to transfer the communication to the district to the zone to the club members. So the process is there. So on this process, how, as a DG, how did you play a role in the cross-level communication? Can you just narrate an experience?
Experience as for the cross-communication?
Cross-level communication. How effective you were able to do it? How effective you are able to promote cross-level communication as a DG, in the DG team?
I communicated all the communications from the zone chairman to my district governor. So that helped him to gain more membership.
To gain more membership. You were able to gain more membership. Clubs were extended or only membership gain was there?
Membership growth.
Membership growth. There was a positive impact membership. On the membership. That's really very nice. Now, I want to have a brainstorm. Have a paper. 3 minutes are allotted for you to do a brainstorm on two different subjects. The first one is that where and when you had this cross-level communication is possible in your district. Where and when the cross-level communication is possible in your district. You have to brainstorm. Where and what and when you were able to have this brainstorming, I mean, on what level you had this cross promotion of this effective communication.
Yes.
3 minutes are allocated benefits for that. Yeah. After that, we'll pass on to the next task.
Benefits. Cross-level communication ki ye hai, that it filtered directly to the clubs from the district to the zones. The clubs is important because, you know, international
channel setup, got reduced.
International setup, clubs are the most important.
Okay, we can say channel get reduced, so there is no miscommunication. Okay, then
first of all, and here international zone means clubs are important. Clubs does all the activity. It is okay. The club. So we have to concentrate on the club, the district. All communication should filter down to the clubs as it is. It should not be wasted, or it should not be added anything.
Okay.
Neither added.
So yeah, it should be as it is.
As it is. Yes, it should
be any change.
No changes should
happen. Whatever.
True.
Okay.
Even cross level communication is there, then all the goals of the district will be achieved very
yes.
easily.
Okay, goals can be achieved. And then in this case, you know, like
which you took example, I mean, for example, you took an example of the diabetes, you know, mm-hmm. the whole district can be doing a single activity in a single day, which will have a great impact on this one.
Okay, so what happens is, you know, like when we have good communication channel, impact can be increased. Okay.
Yes. Service impacting.
Service impacting. Membership increases.
And the other one, you know, like it always helps the clubs to get proper information. Okay. Yes. And then the zone chairman should act in way as a liaison between the club and the
bridge between.
So that he will be a bridge or liaison. So that really makes us better. Okay. So this what can
now
be
finished.
Repeat?
Yeah. Some more time.
Okay.
Who will go into?
Yeah. One point?
All together or 1-1 point?
Benefits of cross-level communication is that the channel is reduced. Mm-hmm. It is a shorter channel. So there are lesser chances of miscommunication. There is no miscommunication. Whatever is said is directly goes percolated the same way.
Yes.
So because of which we can achieve our goals much easier and in a good way. In a good number.
The goals are attainable. Goals are attainable.
And which will eventually increase our service impact.
Service impact. So you are all working as a team.
And also the zone chairman gets the limelight.
Limelight.
Like because district governor is allowing the zone chairperson to act between and then he gives importance to him.
Yes.
So that the motivation, it gets motivated.
He has got the recognition.
Yeah.
Lion Club always emphasizes praise liberally and recognition. If you recognize, the input from the zone and the PSTs will be manifold. So you are recognizing, So we are all working as a team. Can you give what will be when you are doing this effective communication? What are the other leadership qualities which are attached or embedded through the communication skill? Can you just elucidate some points? So you're all working as a team. So what you're reminded when you work as a team? Is it not a team? I mean, when you're working as a team, what leadership quality are able to remember?
Group dynamics gets improved.
Yes.
Okay.
Can someone write, someone of you who has got a neat writing or I didn't do it. Group dynamics then?
Then everybody, there is a clarity amongst all.
Group dynamics then?
Clarity amongst all.
Clarity. Team building.
Yeah, clarity is there.
Clarity is there. Then? Your focus. Your focus.
Yes. No conflicts between the team.
No conflicts. No, that I'm asking about leadership skills.
Okay.
Leadership skills. You are managing others now through this communication.
Yeah.
When you are managing, what are the leadership qualities you are able to understand? It is not implicit. It is explicitly it is not shown. It is only implicit. What are the other leadership qualities you are able to elucidate from this communication skills?
Motivating the member.
True. Exactly. Motivation. Then?
Motivating the every team member. Like.
Motivation. That's the broad word. Then? To Abhijit, you said a word.
Importance to everyone. Importance again, no, it doesn't make a difference.
Conflicts won't arise.
You said motivation, clarity, group. It starts with another word, G. You said it is attainable, I told. I helped you with that word.
G.
Goals are
goals
set.
Are achieved.
Yeah,
achieved.
Goals.
Goal setting. You set a goal and you achieve the?
Achieve the goals.
Goal setting is there.
Collective goal. Collective goal setting.
Then? One more quality? Goals a team. You work as a team.
Yeah. Then
team motivation.
Handling team.
So when you're handling team, you're building a rapport, a relationship.
Yeah, we are able to
building
work with different group members.
Better relationship.
Building relationships.
Yeah.
You work as a team. So team building is there.
Yeah.
So all these things are there when you work properly. Then this is happening, taking place when your communication is very clear, lucid, and if there is no confusion in your communication. Then the next task as a brainstorming is that you being the gap team, how will you promote this cross-level communication? What will be your part? You as a role model, how will you promote the cross-level communication? Just brainstorm and I want you to come with the answer.
Okay.
During our speeches, we propagate more and more importance.
You write it, write it. I'm giving time for you to brainstorm. Vinay sir, you can join them.
Emails also. Internet.
Emails.
Come on.
most importantly in our PhD students, your chairman students.
Ready? Are you ready?
Yeah.
We start with Abhijit. It will be a shared. Each and everyone are going to present one point. Clear? Okay, we'll proceed.
In our speeches, we can include it that how the communication should be.
Then, good.
The newsletters, whatever communication
district,
be, district
newsletters, DG newsletter. Yes.
Can be promoted through whenever we conduct schoolings for the PhD and for the zone chairmans, we can include this as an important aspect that we need to focus on, and that will eventually make it happen.
Make it happen. Then what is your point,
because you know, like communication is very easy these days. Technology, we can use technology, but only
new media technology.
Yeah, lot of people are not tech savvy, but we should make them to learn tech
savvy. Will it help it in rural areas?
That's what I'm saying. A lot of people may not have the tech savvy, but these days, you know, WhatsApp, everybody is using it. So thanks to Jio, they are allowing everyone to have the WhatsApp. So there is 1 GB, 2 GB free every day. So they are using it. So mobile data is not a problem for anyone now.
Then, Vinoy sir?
We can send emails, as already my friend has already told that we can use WhatsApp.
WhatsApp.
The basic thing is that we can use any media, any form. But the last idea is to that we have to send the message, let the message percolate to the clubs.
It should have it should be the right direction.
Yes.
You should have the desired results. It should be result oriented. The progress must be visible.
Yes.
It should be a visible progress. So you agree to that. Okay. Now let us have a recap. We started with ineffective communication.
Okay.
Have you ever undergone any frustrated moment when you were in that ineffective communication? Have you ever undergone any frustrated moment? When you also were a part and parcel of the ineffective communication, definitely there will be some places where what you wanted to convey but were not received. You too would have been frustrated. You too will be in the same emotional strain and drain.
So just now we have seen now the madam, Ruchita madam said 115, lot of people didn't watch the WhatsApp. So that get heavy.
Okay. The first thing itself you are drawing from here itself. Okay. Now, let us again have a recap of our session objectives. We understand that communication, we have recognized that communication is a process. We recognize that communication is a process. For that we had the still of ills of an ineffective communication. Then again it was accentuated through a game. Then we understood that communication is a process where two people are needed, the sender and the receiver, and how it is a circle. It is not a static one. It is not in a kinetic state of energy. It is all in potential, because human language and human mind is a continuous process, so it is always ever fertile. It can be for minutes or it can be for hours. So communication can be for minutes for a small span of time, or it can go for sweet nothings for the lovers, which will continue for more hours. So communication is a process. We have understood the definition, and after that we are now to identify. We have identified perfectly what are the skills of communication effectively. And after identifying, we have acquainted with that. For that acquaintance, for how you have acquainted yourself, we have given a role play. You have effectively made use of the one particular skill, active listening, and you have just showed that you have been prepared as a DG team, how we are going to take this communication at the different level, promote it to the cross level within the district. So I hope this year I'm going to play as a role of the BDG, and you are in a great position, in an enviable position. Each and every line wants to have to attain your position. Remember, this is the year. It is also preparation time for you to dream what you want to achieve when you become a DG, so you learn from this phase itself. Each and every phase in Nainism is a stone for a stepping stone or a ladder of experience where every time we learn and we equip ourselves. So I wish you, congratulate you to be an active part in the DG team, and when you become a DG, the flips and the flaws will help you to grow, and it will help you to reach an zenith where you set a record, because in Nainism only we see a healthy growth. I wish you all success, and if I've got any questions, I'm ready to answer to you. Any questions? Could you just read the quote of John Powell? He was a British musician. He's given a wonderful quote.
Communication works for those who work at it.
Yes, if you are sincerely want to work, definitely works, or it will be a mismatch, there will be conflict, there will be a mad relationship, there will be ill trust, and there will be, instead of harmony, there will be discord, and it is all ends in pandemonium. Your peace is being, peace of mind is shattered. So communication is works for those who really want to work on it. Thank you so much for the opportunity given to you. And I like each and every one of us to be honest, because I told you, feedback is, if you take it in the positive manner, it's going to be good. It's going to offer me direction for me to grow. It's going to give me direction. It helped me to grow in the proper manner.